Welcome back to online classes conducted by the Loyola English Medium School Tuni. Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the how to compare different countries or states. Already you know about the some countries. In that, some of the countries are the developed countries, and some of the countries are the developing countries or not developed countries. At the same time, states. Some of the states are the developed states and some of the states are the not developed states. Here asked the one question, how can you say this answer, which are developed, which are not developed? Do you know that when you are saying that the countries or states, mainly we have compared them in some aspects. About that, first I said the one example. See, once look at the board. Here mention the two students. One student is the X and one student is the Y. Between the two students, now I will say X is the good student and Y is the bad student. How can you say that answer? Do you know? To say that answer, both students we have compared in some aspects. What are the aspects? For example, education, behavior, discipline, and attitude. So these are the some of the aspects I have taken. In that all aspects, we have compared the both students, and finally I am saying G is the good student and B is the bad student. Here also same, to compare the countries we have used the some of the aspects. What are the aspects? Here mention the one of the aspect, income. Income, to compare the countries or to compare the states. Finally, you are saying one is a developed state or one is not a developed state, one is a developing country and one is not a developing country. How can you say that answer? These all are you are compared on the basis of the income. So here we have taken the income as the one indicator or one aspect comparing them. And finally you are saying some are good or some are not good, some are developed or some are not developed. When you are taking income as a indicator, here some countries are the higher income countries. For example, take the higher income countries. Higher income countries always they have the high income, and they are developed countries compared with the low income countries. Compared with the low income countries. So, who are the people living in the higher income countries? Already they have the income or they have the money. With the help of that, what do they need? Immediately they have buy them with the help of the income. And at the same time, who are the people living in that area? They have the one goal. What is that goal? Earning the most of the income compared with the less income countries. Are you understand this? And next, here mentions the income of the country. What is the income of the country? Income of the country means the income is belong to country. What is the country here? Country means people. Country means people. That means people's income. Or who are the residents? Or who are the people living in the country? The income is belonging to them. Or this is called the residents of the country. The income of the residents of the country. This is called total income of the country. Are you understand this? This is the total income of the country. What is the total income of the country? Who are the people living in the country? When they have earned the income, the total income is called the total income of the country. Are you understand this? Already I told you, to compare the countries or compare the states, here we took the income as an indicator. When that is taken as an indicator, at the time, is it giving or not correct information? That is the question. Is it giving or not? It is not giving correct information. When you are taking the income to compare the countries or to compare the states, at the time, it is not giving the correct information. Why? Because population. Some countries are having the more population. Some countries are having the less population. Already I told you, people's income is called total income of the country. That is the country's income. For example, you have to take the one country. One country, there is living the more population. When there was living the more population, all people, if they are doing the work, they have earned the money, automatically they have the more income compared with another country. Why? In another country, there is the less population. So, when there was living the less population, they are doing the work, automatically they have earned the less income. And next, in a country, average, one person, he was earned the how much of the money. That information also not giving. Are you understand this? On the basis of these all aspects, when you have taken the income as an indicator, comparing the countries or comparing the states, it is not giving the correct information about the development of the countries. Are you understand this? So, to comparing the countries, here we have to take the average income of the country. Average income of the country. Average income of the country, it is also called per capita income. What is the per capita income? Per capita income means the total income of the country which is divided by the population. Finally, we have get the one income. Here the income is average income or per capita income. Are you understand this? So, there was used the average income of the country to compare the countries. Are you understand this definition? What is the per capita income? Per capita income means the total income of the country which is divided by the total population of the country. Finally, we have got the one income. The income is the per capita income. It is also called average income. Next one. Here, World Development Report, which is brought by the World Bank 2012. When there was brought the report, on the basis of this report, the entire countries are divided to three categories. Here the countries are divided into three categories. How do they divide it here? On the basis of the income. On the basis of the income. According to that, the countries are high income countries, middle income countries, and low income countries. Now you understand this? Here, first, what are the high income countries? Already I told you, these all countries are divided on the basis of the income. Income means per capita income. Here, which country is per capita income more than $12,600? $12,600. These all countries are called high income countries. Are you understand this point? What are the high income countries? Here, which country's per capita income more than $12,600. These countries are the high income countries. Example, US, Canada, China, Britain, Japan. So these are the some of the examples. And next, second category, middle income countries. What are the middle income countries? Here, these countries per capita income between $1,035 to $12,600. These all countries are called middle income countries. Will you understand this? Which countries per capita income is between $1,035 to $12,600? These all countries are called middle income countries. Example, India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Myanmar. These all countries are middle income countries. And next, low income countries. Here, which countries per capita income below $1,035? Below $1,035. These all countries are called low income countries. Here mention the Afghanistan, Cambodia, and some of the African countries. These all countries are came under the third category. What is the third category? Low income countries. Are you understand this? This is the classification of the countries in the world. And next, India. 1 decade ago, 10 years back, India, it is also under the low income countries. But at present, it is came under the middle income countries. What do you understand about it? Nowadays, the per capita income of the India, it was improved and growing very fast. As a result of that, our country, India, it is came under the middle income countries. And next, what are the developed countries? Already I told you developed countries. Here mentioned some of the West Asian countries and some small countries. Except West Asian countries and some small countries, remaining all countries are called developed countries. What are they? For example, America, Russia, Japan, Germany, Singapore, Britain. So these are the some of the examples of the developed countries. Or understand this? This is the classification of the countries. Next one. Limitations of Everest. Limitations of Everest. Previously, already I told you, to compare in the countries, there was used the per capita income or average income. When we have used the average income, is it giving or not correct information? That is the question. It is not giving correct information. So, now we are going to discuss the limitations of the average. Are you understand this? First, height disparities. About that, here taking the one example, two countries, country A and country B. Country A, how many people living there? 5 people living there. And also here given the 5 people per capita income, 9,500, second person 10,500, and third person 9,800, and fourth person 10,000, and fifth person 10,200. And country B. In country B also living the 5 people.
First person income 500, second person income is 500, and third person income is 500, fourth person income is 500, and fifth person income is 48,000. Are you understand this? Already I told you, what is the per capita income? Per capita income means total income of the country by total population. For example, first you have to take the country A. Total income of the country. Here mention the five persons. First you have add the income of the five persons. 50,000 rupees. This is the total income of the country A. Already I told you, to calculate it, there was taken the total income of the country by total population. 50,000 is the total income of the country A. And how many people are living there? 5 people are living there. 50,000 by 5. If you have calculated this, 10,000 rupees. What I understand about it? When in a country A, living the 5 people, the 5 people's average income is the 10,000 rupees. What it is said? He said each person earned the 10,000 rupees. And next, country B. Here country B also same. First, you have add the income of the 5 persons. The total income of the 5 persons 50,000 rupees. And total population 5 members. If you have calculated this, you have get the 10,000 rupees. What it is in country B also each person is under the 10,000 rupees. Are you understand this? Okay now. Once you have observed the table, according to average, it is that each person is earned the 10,000 rupees. For example, take the country A, first person he was earned the 9,500 rupees. But what is at the average? The person is earned the 10,000 rupees. And fifth person he was earned the 10,200 rupees. But that is that the person is earned the only 10,000 rupees. When you observe this table, among the 5 persons, only this person, 4th person only, he was earned the 10,000 rupees, but remaining all persons, they have earned the less income than the average income, they have earned the more income than the average income. And next, country B also same. Here country B only, 5th person he was earned the 48,000 rupees. Remaining 4 persons, they have earned the only 500 rupees. But what is the average? Each person is earned the 10,000 rupees. Only one person, 5th person, he was earned the more than 10,000 rupees. But that is said, the person also earned the 10,000 rupees. Remaining persons, they are not earned the 10,000 rupees. They have earned the very less income. But that is said, the person was earned the 10,000 rupees. Or understand this? So overall, what I understand about it? When you use the average income comparing the countries, whether it is developed or not, to know it, that is not giving the correct information. That is the height disparities. Average income, height, some disparities. Or understand this? Height, some disparities means country B, as well as the person is earning the 500 rupees only, but that is 10,000 rupees. What about remaining 9,500 rupees? That is height by the average. Are you understand this? So this is about the limitations of the average income. Next, income and other criteria. Already I told you to compare the countries. We are using the income as a indicator. But here not only income, sometimes also we have used the some other aspects compare the countries or states. Already I told you, most of the people nowadays they have the some of the goals, income, equality, respect from others, better wages, freedom, security. So these are having some of the goals. At the same time, when we have compared the states, here not only used the income, also we have used the some other aspects, that is the other criteria. Students, once we have observed the box, the per capita income of the some selective states 2012. What are the states? Here mentioned the three states: Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Bihar. Our understand is, and next also gave here their per capita income. Punjab per capita income 78,000, Himachal Pradesh 74,000, Bihar 25,000. That means in the three states, each person he was earning the such income. Punjab, each person earned the 78,000. Himachal Pradesh, each person earned the 74,000 per capita income. And Bihar, each person's per capita income is 25,000 rupees. Are you understand this? Here mentioned the per capita income of the some selected states. Already I told you, measuring of the development, you have used the one of the indicator. What is that indicator? The indicator is the income. The indicator is the income. According to that, when you have compared these three states, Punjab, it is in the highest place, and Bihar, it is in the bottom. Bottom, that means Punjab is, according to that, Punjab considered developed state. Bihar considered least development state. And Himachal Pradesh, this is in the middle. Are you understand this? He also mentioned the other data, some compared to data of states. What is the data? The data, it is also mentioned for three states, and also taking some of the percentages for three aspects. First, IMR, infant mortality rate, literacy rate, and net attendance rate. According to this table, I think you said Punjab is the developed state and Bihar is the least developed state. And also you should observe this table. Here mentioned the three aspects. For example, IMR, infant mortality rate. What is infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate means per thousand child, how many child died within 1 year. That is called infant mortality rate. Once you have observed them, IMR percentages of the three states 42, 36, 62. Our understand this? Among the three aspects, in which state there is recorded the highest IMR? Bihar. Next, Punjab. Next, Himachal Pradesh 36% only. That means the IMR percentage, the child death, it is less in Himachal Pradesh. And next, literacy rate or literacy percentage. First, you know the what is the literacy. Literacy means those who can read and write, the person is called literacy. Or those who know reading and writing, that is called literacy. How to calculate the literacy percentage in our country? To calculate the literacy percentage, here we have take the a percent, those who are completed the 7 years age or above 7 years. Are you understand this? Once after the literacy percentage of these three states, Punjab 77, Himachal Pradesh 84, Bihar 64. When you compare the three states, in which state recorded the highest literacy rate? Himachal Pradesh. Here, Himachal Pradesh, it is also created the a good progress in the literacy percentage, not only in IMR. Next, net attendance rate, NAR. What is the net attendance rate? Net attendance rate means children, how many children they are going to school in a year. That is called net attendance rate. According to that, in Punjab, 76% of the children they are going to school. Himachal Pradesh 90 and Bihar 56. Okay, now in the net attendance rate, which state created the good progress? Himachal Pradesh created the good progress. Why? In Himachal Pradesh, 90% of the child they are going to school. Our understand this? These are about the IMR literacy net attendance rate. Students, once you have observed the both states, both tables, according to first table, you said Punjab is the developed state. Now say answer, according to second table, which is considered as a developed state? Himachal Pradesh, not Punjab. Why? Himachal Pradesh, here not only income, when you compare the states or countries, here you are not only taking the income, also you have to take some other aspects. These are the other aspects, IMR, literacy and net attendance rate. Here Himachal Pradesh, not only the income and also in some other aspects, it is also created the good progress or achieved the good progress. As a result of that, among the three states, Himachal Pradesh, this is considered as a developed state. All understand this? What understand about it? When you want to compare the any state or any country, not only using the income, also the countries and states, you should compare them in other aspects. In other aspects, which is recorded the good progress, that is considered as a developed country or developed state. Our understand is, this is about the income and other criteria. Okay, children, let's stop here. Again, I will continue tomorrow. Up to now, you have discussed something. Once again, you have read it and you have prepared the sum of the notes. Thank you.